Hey everybody, I'm super excited. Today I am at Osceola Medical Center. OMC is a wonderful sponsor here on the We Are Network. And today we're gonna get a chance to meet and talk to some of the great people that are in charge of the athletic training department and see all the awesome things that they do and the services that they provide here in Osceola and around the We Are Network. Hey everybody, I am super excited to introduce you to OMC's rehab manager, Lynette Johnson. Thanks for taking some time today, Lynette, to kind of walk us through some things here.
Well, thank you for having me.
You're welcome. So let's talk a little bit about Osceola Medical Center, its history, and what you guys provide.
So Osceola Medical Center was founded back in 1932, originally downtown Osceola. Since then, we've expanded and we've moved up to our health campus up here on top of the hill. One of the founding principles when OMC was first developed was community involvement. So how do we make our community as healthy as possible? So back in 2013, Osceola Medical Center decided to hire an athletic trainer. At that time, we hired Tori Zeiss, who's now become Tori Salikar, as many of you have seen around games and events. Under the principle that, you know, we wanted somebody there at that time to follow concussion protocol and help the schools follow what the state guidelines were in regards to having concussions covered in events, safe and healthy for our student athletes.
You provide athletic training services to schools during events, correct?
And practices. Tori is there for all home events. In the fall for football, she goes to all away events also. So those higher impact sports have a higher rate of coverage just in case there's some special needs or injuries that happen.
Obviously you've got Osceola covered. Are there other towns in the area?
So this year we are also providing services at St. Croix Falls Schools, Frederick Schools, Luck Schools, and Unity Schools. Some of the other events that we cover are we do an annual athletic screening night. So the athletes can come in, they see a medical provider, they see physical therapy, they do their concussion impact baseline testing. And so they get their cards ready, their eligibility ready to play sports in the fall.
What does an athletic trainer do?
She is helping the school district follow the emergency action plan to start out with. So if there is an injury, they have a set guidelines that she helps them follow. An example is during the football games, she makes sure that the ambulance is either on site or available to provide coverage as needed.
What are the risk factors and what are kind of the risks involved in high school athletics?
As kids are getting more competitive, they're participating in multi-sports. There's a higher risk of injury. In fact, I believe it's 62% of injuries are within our high school athletic programs that are seen in the ED department for sports-related injuries. So we want to make sure we capture them and make sure that, again, they don't happen again. So, you know, you have the athlete who is running an intense event for cross country who goes down. We don't want them to go to another event the next day without making sure they're safe and they're not risking themselves.
Awesome. Do you guys provide anything for coaches or leaders?
Yep. So we work closely with the coaches. The athletic trainer's available if they need somebody seen right away. But yearly, we try to work with them to do a coach's clinic, which provides like the hot topics, the hot trends that they're interested in.
If somebody wanted to have you at their school, do they just give you a call or how does that work?
They would actually contact either me or Melody Jacobs, our athletic health coordinator, who would then help set up a contract and see, you know, what we have available for services.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Lynette.
Thank you.
All right, I'm joined now by Will Ryan. He is the head of the athletic training department here at OMC, and we are so thankful that you were able to take a couple minutes out of your busy schedule. Thanks for joining us.
Absolutely.
All right, so say a player gets hurt on the field, and they're okay, but they need to progress and get, you know, return to play. So
sure.
That's kind of where you come in, right? Like, what is your role here?
So I come in probably a little bit after they get hurt. So I'm at some of the events. So typically, student athlete gets injured. They will be assessed by the athletic trainer who is trained to provide those services.
Will they make a diagnosis on the field?
Yep, depending on the severity of injury, a lot can happen. Sometimes, whether, you know, if it's cramping or kind of more mild injury, they could be treated quickly on the sideline and then return to the game.
So let's say I asked a kiddo who gets injured, what's the benefit of seeing the athletic trainer?
The athletic trainer can provide necessary treatments and assessment at their level, and then they can always refer to me, potentially, or physical therapy. The benefit is that then they get attention of the athletic trainer who has direct contact with me to provide a quick interpretation of what they are finding so that I can determine whether they need to be seen in clinic or if it can kind of just be watched at the athletic training level. I think the other value that I provide when I'm at a medical event is to help to determine if a specific student athlete needs further medical assessment at that time.
Well, again, it's Will Ryan. He's the head of the athletic training department here at OMC, and we're so thankful that you took some time out of your busy schedule to talk to us. Thank you again.
Thank you.
All right, now I am joined by Tori Salikar. She is the head athletic trainer here at Osceola Medical Center, and she's agreed to take just a few minutes to tell you a little bit about what she does. She's kind of where the rubber meets the road here, and thank you so much for joining us, and can't wait to learn a little bit about you. So how did you get involved with this? When did you start? And tell us a little bit about yourself.
I started here at Osceola Medical Center in 2013, and then in turn just started right at the Osceola School District.
Yeah, 2013. That was kind of ahead of the curve is what I'm gathering.
It was, yep, it was right about in that time where most schools are requiring athletic trainers to be on site for most athletic events. Not necessarily always there after school, but Osceola School District gets the luxury of having me every single day after school.
So what is a typical game day like for you? What's your prep and everything?
Game days usually start right after school when the bell rings, so the kids are allowed to come into my room then, and we either get taped up and ready to go, or they might run off and grab dinner, and I do, you know, water prep, packing my medical kit, getting things ready so when they get back, we are going to the game.
I heard you guys do coaches, clinics, teach them how to tape, teach them how to do some other things. Are you involved in that?
Yes, so we have done coaches, clinics here where I try to, if, say, they need to go somewhere and I can't get to school before they leave on their bus, coaches are able to tape an ankle or tape a wrist, help me out a little bit if need be. Athletes appreciate that very much.
Yeah, and I'm sure you've seen lots of different injuries from calves, you know, cramping up to major injuries. I know you guys have a relationship with EMS, is that correct?
Yes, so we partner with Osceola Area Ambulance and the EMS staff there. They are awesome. We have them on site for football games, which is a requirement kind of in a nutshell. I mean, usually EMS has to be on standby within a couple blocks. So our guys tend to sit and watch the game with us, and they're awesome. They're always willing to help.
So what is the continuation of care? What does it look like if a kid gets injured and they need some further care? What happens then?
If they do not need EMS services, which is usually not the case, I can get in touch with Will at the clinic or any of the doctors that would be willing to see. But Will is our first go, and if I can get them in with him the next day or day after, depending on if it falls on a weekend or not, then we try to get them in here and then go from there.
Wow, that's some great care. Fantastic. Is there anything else you'd like to say before we wrap things up?
If anyone ever needed anything, I mean, they definitely don't hesitate to reach out. I mean, track me down at a game somewhere. I'm always available to answer any questions.
Well, if her voice sounds familiar, Tori has been on a bunch of We Are Osceola broadcasts, and
yes,
we thank you for doing that, too.
No problem.
All right. Tori Salikar, thank you for joining us, and have a great spring season.
Thank you very much.